इज दिस पीडीएफ विजिबल? Okay, so in the Google Classroom, I have shared you the textbook PDF copy. Here, this is the textbook for linear algebra and its application. You can just check it there. This is the textbook, and here you have to refer for the determinants and eigenvalues and eigenvectors. Here, this is the fourth chapter and fifth chapter. So just check there. Okay. So let me share. So yesterday we have started with the fifth module. First we are seeing the determinants part. So every square matrix can be associated with an expression or a number. And this number can be positive, negative, and zero. And it can also be some expression. And it is only called as determinant. And if this is the square matrix we take of order n, here we have taken n cross n matrix. Here we have n cross n matrix, and the determinant we just represent it like this. Okay, all the elements here remains the same, just we take the parallel lines, and this is for the n cross n general matrix. And this determinant is only for the square matrix. Okay, so this all we had seen. Then we had seen the determinants of order 1, that is 1 cross 1 matrix. So it will have only one element, and the determinant of this matrix will be that element itself. So here the determinant of this A matrix will be A11. Or here if you take, the determinant of this matrix will be 2. Or here if there is some expression, the determinant, if you can solve that expression, the determinant will be that value. Here it is 7. If there is some general equation or the expression given, the determinant will be that value itself. Here the determinant is 7. Then we have seen the determinant of order 2. Here there will be 2 cross 2 matrix. This is the 2 cross 2 square matrix. So if you want to find the determinant, you have to do the cross multiplication. So this is the determinant. You have to do the cross multiplication. Either you can do downwards multiplication or upwards multiplication and use the negative sign in between. Okay, so this is as it is product. You can do anyhow these multiplication. Then we have seen some example. Here we have got the negative value for the determinant. And then we have seen another example where we got the zero value. Then we have seen the order 3 determinant. Here this is the general determinant we have used. This is the general matrix of 3 cross 3. That is order 3 matrix. And here if you want to find the determinant of this matrix, you can do about any row. Here there are 3 rows. You can use any row from this, or you can expand using any column, but here we have expanded using the first row. So here you have to take the first element, and when you take this first element A11, you have to neglect this first row and this first column. So whatever the submatrix will remain after neglecting this, this is the these are the 4 elements you get. So that determinant of those submatrix you have to take. Here for the second one you have to take A12, and here this will be positive as it is the even number, that is 1 plus 1 even. So first one will be positive, and 1 plus 2 if you see, this will be odd number. So here you have to take the negative sign, and for this you have to neglect this first row and second column. So when you neglect, you get these 4 elements. So that determinant you have to take. Similarly for the third element also, A13, here if you neglect this row, first row and third column, these are the 4 elements you get. So this is the submatrix you get. So here if you see, this is the order 2 determinant. So you can just do the cross multiplication and write. So this is the expression you get. This is the general expression. So we have seen some problems also for the 3 cross 3 matrix. and also 2 cross 2 matrix. Then next we have seen this one simple example for the identity matrix. So today we will see the properties of determinant. So first property, yesterday we had already seen, using this example, the determinant of identity matrix will be always 1. Yesterday you also solved and checked for this, so you got the determinant as 1 itself. So whenever there is an identity matrix and if you take the determinant of that, you will get the determinant as 1 itself. Okay, so this is the first property of the determinant. The identity matrix will have 1 only in the diagonals and other values will be equal to 0. So here this is one property. Next one is the determinant changes sign when two rows are exchanged. Whenever we exchange the rows, that is if we exchange this first row and second row, then there will be sign changes. So here this is the matrix we have and determinant of this will be CB, so cross multiplication CB minus AD. So this is the determinant value we get. Just first you just neglect this minus sign, and here if you have exchanged this value, here you have exchanged the rows here. First you have taken AB here. This AB you have taken in the first row and CD you have taken in the second row. So now you have exchanged the rows. So here if you take the determinant, that is AD minus BC. So this value you get. So if you just take the negative sign here, you will get this CB minus AD, which is same as this one. So these two are equal. Whenever you take the row exchange, one time row exchange if you take, it will become minus. So here whenever you change the rows, the sign will change. Again if you change this row, again if you make this as the first row and this as the second row, now this minus sign will become plus. So how many times you do the row exchanges, those many times the sign will change. Okay, this is the second property. You just take down these two properties. First one is the determinant of identity matrix is 1. So you can take determinant of I is equal to 1, or you can take parallel line I is equal to 1. You can just take this example. Determinant can be for any order. Here this is for second order. Here this is for the order 3. For more number of order, that is order 4, 5 also, the identity matrix will have the determinant value as 1 itself. So this is the first property, the identity matrix determinant will be 1. Next one is the determinant changes sign when two rows are exchanged. Here this is the first matrix they have given. When you change the row, here the row is changed. First AB is taken, then CD. The determinant for this is CB minus AD, and the determinant of this is AD minus CB. But you have changed the row, so you have to take negative. So when you take negative with this, these two determinants will be same, that is CB minus AD. Here also when you take this negative sign inside, you get CB minus AD. So this will be equal to the negative of this. So again if you change the row of this, first if you take CD then AB, one negative sign is there, and again you have to take the negative sign for that also. So negative into negative, it will become positive and you get this same. If there are odd number of exchanges, row exchanges, you get negative, and if there are even number of row exchanges, you get positive value. This you will understand when solving the numerical. This is some general expression given here. We will take some numbers and solve that. So in this property only, there is some special case, that is permutation matrix. Here the permutation matrix determinant will be always equal to plus or minus 1. So here just I will tell what is permutation matrix, but separately we have the next section about this. But here just I'll tell what it is. Okay, here this permutation matrix, the determinant is always plus or minus 1. Here if you see this example, this is the identity matrix. You already know this. Here 1, 1 will be there in each row. And if each column if you see, only 1, 1 will be there. And these all 1 are in the diagonal, are arranged diagonally. But here in this P matrix, if you see, here also there is only 1, 1 in each row. In each row only 1, 1 is there and other elements are 0. And in each column also, if you see, there is only 1, 1 and other elements are 0. But here these are not arranged diagonally. They are just scattered. So this identity matrix is the special case of this permutation matrix. So what is permutation matrix? Here also there are only 1, 1s. Here every row has only 1, 1 and every column has only 1, 1. Just if you just rearrange or exchange the rows, here this row if you take to the first one, here it becomes 1000, here 1000, and this if you take to the third row, this becomes 0010. So if you exchange these two rows, that is the first row and the third row, if you exchange, that becomes the identity matrix only. So you have made one row exchange, and if you take the determinant, that is determinant of this is 1. Whenever you get the upper or lower triangular matrix, you have to just take the multiplication of the diagonal elements. So here if you just multiply these, here you get the determinant as 1. So here you have made one row exchange. If you just exchange this third row and the first row, one row exchange, so minus sign will be there and the diagonal elements only will be 1. So the determinant is minus 1 here. So you can get the determinant of P as plus 1 or minus 1 always. So this also you can just take. Here you can just read this point. The determinant of every permutation matrix, that is determinant of P is plus or minus 1. And by row exchanges, we can turn the P matrix into identity matrix. So here we have made one row exchange and turned this P matrix into identity matrix. So if you just exchange this third row and first row, you will get the identity matrix. And each row switch the sign of the determinant. So here one row exchange we did, we get the minus sign. So until we reach the determinant of I is equal to 1. So that is what same it is written here. Just take down this also. It is in the same property itself. In the second property only, this also is included. This I have written just for your understanding. Every row when you switch, the sign will change. Here one time if we exchange this rows, we get the sign change. Here we get, this is odd number, one time we have exchanged, so we get minus. And the determinant of that identity matrix is 1. So minus 1 we get here. If there are even number of row exchanges, if there is some other matrix given where 1 is positioned somewhere else. So if we make 2 row exchanges, if we are getting the identity matrix, then it will be determinant of that matrix is 1. Just you can take here this determinant is equal to plus or minus 1. and this permutation matrix, identity matrix, is the special case of permutation matrix. If you want, you can just write this. So by seeing this, you will understand. And you have to make some row changes in the permutation matrix to get the identity matrix, and number of row changes will just change the sign. So next property we can see. Here these properties are very important while solving the numericals. And in exams, like 80 to 90% from this module, you get problems only. Theory questions are very less. 1 or 2 theory questions you get. But you have to remember all these things to solve the numericals. These things are only applied, so you have to know the theory part also. So next property we will see. The determinant depends linearly on the first row. Here we will just see. Here suppose this A, B, C are the three matrix considered. And from the second row, from the second row down, you have the same elements. And row 1 is linear combination of first rows B and C. So here, if you see, this has the A matrix, this has the B matrix, and this has the C matrix. So here these are the three things considered. And from the second row down, these are same. Here if you see, this is the second row, and if you have any number of rows from the second row, you have same elements. Here CD, and here also CD, here also CD. So the from second row, you have the same elements. Here everywhere it is CD from the second row. And here from the row 1 of A is linear combination of first rows of B and C. Here if you see, this B has AB. And this C matrix has A dash and B dash. For the A matrix, you have the linear combination of this B and C matrix. So here it is A plus A dash, B plus B dash. So that is what is written in the sentence. Here A matrix, B matrix and C matrix are considered. And from the second row, these all three matrix have the same elements. And the first row of A, it is the linear combination of B and C matrix. So in such cases, it is just the combination of B and C matrix. So the determinant is also just the combination of B and C matrix. So here if you solve the determinant for this, here if you just do the cross multiplication, you get AD plus A dash D, and minus here you get CB and minus CB dash. That is what you get as the determinant, right? If you solve the determinant for this, just do the cross multiplication here. You get AD plus A dash D and minus sign. And here it is BC minus B dash C. So separately, if you do the this one determinant here also. Here for the first one, you get AD minus BC. Here also you have AD minus BC. And here for this, if you do plus A dash D minus B dash C. So here also you get the same determinant value. So it is just the linear combination of both B and C. Whenever you have the first row as the combination of two matrix, it is the linear combination of B and C matrix. And from the second row, you have the same elements. Here it is CD for all the three matrix. Here from the second row, they have the same elements. So the determinant is just same for these both. So here it is, the determinant of A is just the linear combination of B and C. And linear combination can also be in terms of multiplication. So here if you see the multiplication by T in the first row, here this matrix, if you consider AB and CD, here this T is multiplied outside. And here if you see, this is CD here. From the second row you have same elements. Here it is CD and here also it is CD. But here if you see, this T is outside. And here if you see, this T is multiplied for the first row. Only for the first row you have the T multiplication. And for this, from the second row, these have same elements. So for this, if you see the determinant, here it is TA into D cross multiplication and minus TB into C. So this is what you get the determinant value. Here also if you take the determinant AD minus BC and then multiply the T. So it becomes T into AD minus T into BC. So these also have the same determinant. So either of these will have the same determinant. Here this T is outside and then if you take the determinant of A and here determinant of T into A, these both are same. So you can have the linear combination with respect to this addition, or you can have with respect to this multiplication. The determinant equations will be like this. Here it can be combination of two matrix, or you will get the in terms of multiplication like this. Okay, so just you can read it once so you will understand. The determinant depends linearly on first row. Here from the second row in both the cases you have the same elements. CD is same here also while doing addition, and here also CD is same for the multiplication case. So it depends only upon the first row. So the determinant depends linearly on the first row. These are the three matrix considered here, and from the second row you have the same elements, and the first row it is linear combination of B and C. Here it is the linear combination of this B and C matrix. So if you take the determinant of this and the determinant of these two separately, if you take the determinant of B and C then add, you get the same determinant value as this one. So here then the rule says, here the determinant A is same combination of determinant B and determinant C, and this is linear combination they have said. So linear combination involves adding and also multiplying. So here these are the two cases you get. Here when you just multiply the T only to the first row, or if it is common, here it is outside this determinant. So if you take the determinant of this or the determinant of this, you will get the same determinant value. This is the general equation, that is determinant of T into matrix A or T into determinant of A, it will be same. So we can just take this also, just take these equations, no need to take down this, just take these equations. While solving problems, when you use these properties, you will be more cleared. Just take down these two. So next property we will see. Here, when two rows of A matrix are equal, then the determinant of A is 0. Here, if you see, these two rows are same. Here it is AB and here also AB. The determinant of this will be 0. Because when you do cross multiplication, here it is A into B and minus A into B. So here the determinant is always 0 whenever you have two rows as equal. So this is one property. You can just take down this also. If two rows of A are equal, then the determinant of A is 0. Then next one, subtracting a multiple of one row from another row leaves the same determinant. Here if you consider one determinant, here ABCD, determinant of this is AD minus BC. And here they have told if you multiply, if you just subtract a multiple of one row. Here this is one row AB and the other row is CD. So the multiple of this row if you take, here some multiple L if you take, L into C, the multiple of C and multiple of D if you take and just subtract from this A and B. Here this is the multiple of this C and we are subtracting from A, A minus LC. And here the multiple of D, LD is taken and we are subtracting from B. So whenever you are subtracting a multiple of one row, here the multiple of this row, that is LC and LD, we are subtracting from the another row, that is B and that is A and B. So here this is the thing that they have told in the statement. Whenever we are subtracting a multiple of one row from the another row, we get the same determinant value. Here we will see how we will get. Here this is the determinant we have taken, and from the rule 3, here we have seen the rule 3 where we had the same. Here this we, if we take A matrix, B matrix and C matrix, as in the rule 3 we have seen. Here if we take from the rule 3, here from the second row we have same elements, that is CD, and this first row, if you see, here it is the linear combination of this B and C matrix. Here it is, we had taken their addition in the rule 3. Here it is subtraction. It can be any linear combination, plus or minus. So here it is A minus LC and B minus LD. Here it is the linear combination of both these matrix. So here you can write this matrix like this also. A, B, C, D plus minus LC, minus LD, C and D. Here from the second row, they have same elements. And the first row is the linear combination of these two matrix. So this, if you keep it as it is, in the third rule itself, here T was taken. Here in the third rule, if you see, this one we had seen now. This addition part, this CD was same. And here it is A minus LC and B minus LD in the, so here it is. Next one, if you see this one multiplication, here it is minus L and minus L here. Here if you see, here it is minus L into C, minus L into D. This you can write it like this also. Just take it outside. Like we have taken this T outside in this property. Here T is outside. And here only in the first row we have T and the second row we have CD for both the terms. So here also we have CD here. So just keep this as it is and only take minus L outside from this first row. So if you take minus L outside, you get CD and CD. So here from this previous property, whenever the two rows are equal, the determinant will be 0. So here we have two rows as equal CD and CD. So the determinant of this will be 0. So here this part will become 0. And here we get the determinant ABCD. So this is what we have seen in this property. Subtracting a multiple of one row from another row leaves the same determinant. Here this we have solved and we got this same determinant. Here you see we have got the same determinant. So just see this once again. Write down this by using the third rule and also by using the fourth rule. We have seen this property. First, if you see from the third rule, it is the addition linear combination. So this CD will be same throughout for these two matrix and it is the linear combination of these two. Here A, B and minus LC, minus LD. So it is linear combination. First row is linear combination of the two matrix and from the second row we have same elements. So here this you can split and write like this and only this part if you see here it is the multiplication part from the third rule. So here this first row only have the multiplication and second row has CD value. So this second row you keep it as it is. And from the first row, you can take minus LC outside. If you take this minus LC outside, here these two rows will become same. So whenever the two rows are same from the fourth rule, we have the determinant value as 0. So this part will become 0. So you will get only this determinant value, that is ABCD. So the determinant of this was AD minus BC. And the determinant of this is also AD minus BC. So whenever you subtract the multiple of one row from the another row, you get the same determinant value. You can take down this equation. You can just write this. If you don't want the proof, you can just write this and remember this. The next property. So we will see the next property. Here if A matrix has a row of zeros, then the determinant of A is 0. If there is a matrix which has a row of zeros, here we have the first row as 0 and we have the second row values as C and D. If you have full row as 0, then you will get the determinant as 0. Here even if you do the cross multiplication and see, it is 0 into D minus 0 into C. So you get the determinant value as 0. So this is one of the property. If any matrix has a row of zeros, then the determinant is equal to 0. Then if you see the next property, here if A is the triangular matrix, then determinant of A is just the product of the diagonal elements, that is A11, A12 up to ANN. These are the diagonal elements. Whenever A is the triangular matrix, determinant of A is the product of the diagonal elements. And if the triangular has once along the diagonal, that is if the diagonal elements has only once in the here if it is A is equal to 1, D is equal to 1, Like that, if you have diagonal elements value as 1 everywhere, then the determinant of that value will be equal to 1. So here triangular matrix means you have the zeros for the, here if you see, this is the triangular matrix. Here you have 0 and here you have the 3 elements. Here this upper element is 0 and here you have the 3 elements. So if you take the determinant, here it becomes A into D minus B into 0. So you get AD as the determinant. In this example also, if you see, here just this is this row exchange is done. Here this first column is made as first row, and here it is the upper triangular matrix taken. So here also if you see, it is AD minus C into 0. So here also you get the AD as the determinant value. For the 3 cross 3 matrix, if you check, we will see in the example, the triangular matrix. There also we get the multiplication of the diagonal elements as the determinant value. And in this diagonal elements, if all the elements are 1, then you get the determinant as 1. If any one of the diagonal entries is 0, then you get the determinant value as 0. So that is what is written here. If A is the triangular matrix, then the determinant of A is just the product of the diagonal elements. Here the diagonal elements, if you see, here it is A into D. Here also if you see, the diagonal element is A into D. So it is just the product of the diagonal elements. And if the diagonal elements present in the matrix are equal to 1, here if A is equal to 1, B is equal to 1, then the determinant will be equal to 1. Here also, in this case, if A is equal to 1, D is equal to 1, then the determinant value is equal to 1. But whenever the triangular matrix is singular, singular means the determinant value will be 0. So here when the determinant value will become 0, either this A must be 0 or D must be 0. Then that is there must be some 0 value in the diagonal element, then the determinant becomes 0. So whenever the determinant is 0, we call that matrix as singular matrix. Okay. So all the singular matrix have the 0 determinant. So this is one property. This we will see in the example when we get the 3 cross 3 matrix, how the triangular matrix will look like. There also the determinant is calculated just by multiplying the diagonal elements. So this property you can just take. Whenever A is triangular, diagonal entries you have to multiply to get the determinant of that A matrix. If all the diagonal elements are having the value 1, then the determinant value is equal to 1. If there is any 0 element in the diagonal, you will get the determinant value as 0, and that matrix we call it as singular matrix. So next property is also same, that is if A is singular, then determinant of A is equal to 0. Then if the determinant of A is not equal to 0, then A is invertible, that is it will have the inverse value. Here the A inverse will exist. For the singular matrix, A inverse will not exist because the determinant value is equal to 0. So here if you just see, this determinant of this is AD minus BC. If this is equal to 0, then we call it as the singular matrix. If this is not equal to 0, then it is the invertible matrix. Here A inverse will exist for this matrix. Okay, so this is one property. Whenever A is, that is determinant of A is 0, we have the singular matrix. And whenever the determinant of A is not equal to 0, it is the invertible matrix, that is the inverse of this matrix will exist. So here next property, if you see, it is regarding the product of the determinants. Here the determinant of A into B, here if you take the determinant of A into B matrix, that is equal to the separate determinant of A into the determinant of B. This is what is the rule. If you first multiply A and B, then take the determinant, it is equal to first take the determinant of A and take the determinant of B and then multiply. Both these will have the same determinant value. Here if you see, here this is the A matrix, this is the B matrix. So here if you just take the determinant AD minus BC into, here it will be EH minus GF. That if you just take the multiplication, if you do, then take the simplification for this, that will be equal to this value, determinant of this. Here first only you have to multiply. Here A into E plus B into H, this is the first element you get. Then A into F plus B into H, this is the second element. C into E, D into G, here this is the third element. C into F, D into G, this is the fourth element. So here if you just take the determinant separately and then if you multiply, or if you first multiply and then take the determinant, you will get the same determinant values. This is one of the properties of the determinants. Okay, so here if you see, if this is one determinant, that is determinant of A, and this is another determinant, if you just multiply, that is determinant of A inverse. Here this is determinant of A and determinant of B. By using this property, if we write, that is determinant of A into determinant of B is equal to determinant of A into B. So here it becomes A into A inverse. Whenever there is A into A inverse for the same matrix, then you get the determinant value as I. Determinant of I, you already know, that is the identity matrix you get here. So the determinant of I is equal to 1. So if you want to calculate the determinant value for A inverse, here this is the formula. Here, because determinant of A into determinant of A inverse is equal to 1. So here just if you take this term here, that is 1 divided by determinant of A, you get the determinant of A inverse. This you will use in the numericals. In this, that is product rule, the special case for this is determinant of A inverse is equal to 1 divided by determinant of A. Okay, just take down this rule also. You can just take this product rule, this equation you can take, and you can take this equation. So this is the last property, I think, here. So the transpose of A, here the transpose of A, that is just the rows and columns will be exchanged for the transpose. So it has the same determinant value as A, that is determinant of A transpose is equal to the determinant of A. Here if you see, the determinant of A is, here it is AD minus BC. If you take the transpose, that is if you change this column as row, that is here AC if you take as the row, here AC is taken as row, and BD if you take as this second row. So here if you take the determinant, here also it is AD minus BC. Here also it was AD minus BC. So the transpose rule is A, that is determinant of A is equal to the determinant of A transpose. So there are almost 10 properties for the determinants, and these all properties we will use in solving the numericals. Okay, so just take down this also. In the textbook you can check all these properties, or I'll share this notes also. So from the next class we will solve numericals related to these rules. We will use in the numericals and solve the determinants, and then we will see the next part of this, that is permutation and cofactors. Okay, that is from this determinants module. Okay, so just see all these 10 properties once again. If you see, it will be easy for you whenever you solve the numericals. So from the next class we will solve the numericals related to these. So before that you just glance all these properties once. Here there are 10 properties we have seen. First property is related to identity matrix. The identity matrix determinant will be always equal to 1, and whenever you do the row exchanges, here if you just change the first row and second row, the determinant of this will be negative of the this determinant, because one row exchange here you have done. So negative of this will be having the same determinant value. Here if you see, this determinant value and this determinant value is same. Whenever you take the row exchanges, the signs will change. For odd number of row exchanges, negative sign you get. For even number of row exchanges, you get positive sign. And the permutation matrix will have the determinant value as plus or minus 1. Here the permutation matrix, you can do row exchanges and make it as identity matrix. So depending upon the number of row exchanges, you get plus or minus 1 as the determinant. Next we have seen the linear property for this determinants in terms of addition and also multiplication. Here you get the, from the second row you have the same elements, here also same elements will be there. Only the first row here for the addition, it is linear combination of the two matrix present here. So the determinant, if you do the separate addition and take the determinant, or first only if you add and take the determinant, the values will be same for the determinants. And here for the multiplication, this t is outside and here it is multiplied for each term in the row. So the determinant values will be same for each type of this. And then we have seen whenever two rows are equal, we have the determinant value as 0. And if you just subtract the multiple of one row from the another row, here the multiple of C and D are taken and subtracted from A and B. So the determinant of this and only this, it will be same. That we have proved using the rule 3. That is both the addition and multiplication rule. From the rule 3 we have used, and also the rule 4 we have used, and we have checked this is equal to the determinant of AB and CD. And then we have seen whenever we have the row of zeros, then the determinant of A is 0. Here there is a row of zeros, determinant of this is 0. And whenever there are triangular matrix, only the diagonal entries are multiplied to get the determinant of that matrix. So if there is there are only one values in the diagonals, that is all the values are equal to 1, then you get the determinant value as 1. And if there is any 0 in the diagonal element, then the determinant value will be equal to 0. So whenever the determinant value is 0, we call that matrix as singular matrix. If determinant is not equal to 0, then it is invertible matrix. Then these are the product rule we had seen. That is, determinant of A into determinant of B is equal to determinant of A into B. And determinant of A inverse is equal to 1 divided by determinant of A. And this is related to the transpose rule. Here, that is, determinant of A is equal to determinant of A transpose. So from the next module, we will solve the numericals. Okay. So before that, you just go through these rules. I'll take the attendance.